While I was in legal aid, this lady came to see me by the name of Alfreda Webb. She was on a walker when she came into my office. She was an African-American lady, and like many grandmothers, was raising two grandchildren. And on the way home from work one night, she was struck head-on by an uninsured drunk driver. I think those words go together, uninsured drunk driver. And it disabled her. She couldn't go back to work. And she had to have a car in order to take those grandchildren back and forth to school and to the doctors and everything else. She got $6,800 from her property damage, her own property damage coverage. And she was a good consumer. She went, you know, at the little convenience store, it has those little booklets that say auto trader. She went through one of those auto traders till she found one that said 0% financing, warranty with every sale. And so the mistake she made was she told the salesman, when she got there, she said, "I only have $6,800. She should never have told me how much she had. And he says, "I've got," and she told him, says, "I've got to have a vehicle that works and will not break down, because I have these two grandchildren, and I have to go to the doctor, and they have to go to the doctor, and they have to go to school." And the salesman brought this car around. He said, "I've driven this car myself. It is a good car. I've had it checked out, and you need not worry about it." He said, "But, however," he said, "there are a few add-on fees." There was a $395 document. There was a $287 title preparation fee, even though in Georgia it's only $21 to transfer a title. And the warranty. You added it all together and it was $1,243.36. And he says, "Don't worry, we'll finance that at 29% interest." And she says, "Well, what about the 0% interest?" He said, "Well, that's only for folks with perfect credit." And says, "You don't have perfect credit." She had driven the car less than 50 miles when it broke down. She had it towed back to the dealership. When she got back there, the salesman was gone. And so the manager came out. And he told her, she said, "Listen, he guaranteed me this car and said that it was good. And it's not. It broke down really on the way home." And he says, "Lady, you bought that car as is, where it is, and that's it." And she said, "Well, what about the warranty to fix it?" He said, "That warranty has to be in existence 6 months before we will pay under the warranty." Now, she did what any normal citizen would do. She called the police. And the police came down there, and he told her, he said, "Ma'am, I feel sorry for you, but this is a civil matter." So she goes up to the small claims court in Cobb County, and representing herself on a walker, the magistrate judge gave her a judgment for $7,000. I knew right then he knew more than I did about this case. And by the way, they sold the car because she didn't pay the $1,243. They got a $10,000 for the car that they never paid her So anyway, then the lawyer for the car lot did what he was entitled to do. He demanded a jury trial in the from the magistrate court to the Superior Court of Cobb County. And in she came on a walker to Legal Aid. And she said, now I can handle this in small claims court, but I don't know anything about a jury trial. And I said, well, if they want a jury trial, we will give them a jury trial. So I amended her homemade complaint up, and I put a count in for fraud, and I put a count in for RICO, I put a count in for everything there was, and I demanded it. I said, you want a jury trial? I want it to go to the top of the calendar. Well, then things became interesting. The lawyer on the other side, he called me up and he says, what does she want? I said, she wants a new car. I said, we know that a new car has a warranty and it'll go. I had called CarMax up, they were a Chrysler dealer. And I got the price for a new car, small, but very serviceable. It was $19,000. And I told them what I was doing. They said, listen, we'll sell it to you. And says, we'll lock in a little money on it. So anyway, to make a long story short, after we struck a jury, and I gave the opening statement, they decided to buy Alfreda a new car. And as we were leaving the courthouse, she hugged my neck and thanked me. And as she hobbled away, I wondered to myself, and I thought, you know, if she had not had a lawyer, what would have happened? She would have gotten up there to the Superior Court. She wouldn't have known how to strike a jury. She wouldn't have known the rules of evidence. She wouldn't know how to lay the foundation of documents that we all do every day as a matter of course because we've done it for so many years. And she would have lost her case. But even worse than that, she would have lost the confidence in the judicial system. That is what legal aid and legal services is all about. It is to make sure that we not only represent those that deserve it, but that we make sure they don't destroy the confidence in the judicial system.